2030, 80% of the world's population will live in urban areas. And the way we use energy in these environments will dramatically impact how we live, work, and grow as a community.
That's why Ryerson University created the Center for Urban Energy, or CUE for short. Here in downtown Toronto, world-class researchers, students, and partners are solving urban energy issues.
It was about time that we started to focus on some of the issues that urban centers were facing to make our systems more efficient for our customers.
It's an old system that was built, most of which after the Second World War, and is in desperate need of renewal.
It's basically about modernization and leveraging technology that we have.
Getting the most out of what you have is what renewable energy sources, such as wind and solar, are all about. But it's not always windy or sunny when you need it. CUE's Energy on Time project solves that challenge by using an innovative approach to store clean energy and then make it available when it's needed.
This is the first flywheel in the world that has been able to store energy over, you know, many, many hours at a time. Over an 8 to 10 hour period, we'll only lose about 5% of the energy due to frictional losses.
Say if the flywheel is the muscle, Energy on Time was the brain that helped it to use its capabilities as efficient as possible.
It's really world beating, in my opinion. It's small, it's contained, and it can be put in right where the problems are.
Homeowners want to live comfortably, but keeping energy bills under control all year round can be a challenge. CUE's intelligent home sensor gets rid of all the guesswork by monitoring and adjusting energy usage without compromising the homeowner's comfort.
What is missing is the energy management devices to bridge the gap between informing the homeowners of their energy consumption and optimizing the complex operation of the HVAC units.
Intelligent home sensor makes all the appliances like television, heating, ventilation, lights, everything communicate to each other, which saves money and also save energy.
What is the action we're looking for? To really shift the demand off of peak times when the system is so overstressed and be able to move it in periods when the system is at rest.
Innovation comes in many forms. That's why we created a business incubator and accelerator called IQ for energy entrepreneurs. Here, companies like Plug and Drive are creating solutions for electric cars in urban environments.
We live in a condensed city where millions of people live in a pretty small footprint area. And the electric car and its distances of the batteries that are ideally suited for that kind of application.
Our studies show about 80% of people charge at home. But the reality is, to get people on board with electric cars, they need to see stations out in the public realm.
If we want to have more people using electrical cars, we have to make this transition easier and simple for them. That's what our system does.
Before long, you're going to see charging stations sprinkled throughout the downtown core.
Universities are hotbeds of research and innovation. What we've been able to do in our work with Ryerson in particular is to say, here's where we're going. Here are the issues that we're having. How can you help us? And how can we help you direct your research in a way that's going to be useful to industry?
If we're going to build the system over, what are we going to build it to look like? How is it going to perform for us? What technologies are we going to use? How will those technologies change the relationship we have with our customer today? And so our relationship with CUE really provides us that expert, smart, young, technology-savvy thought process on what Toronto Hydro will look like 50 and 100 years from now.
At the Centre for Urban Energy, our researchers, students, and partners are working to solve tomorrow's energy problems today. So check us out. Visit our website or just drop by.